I have good news for you. God says, get ready. I have good news for someone. God says, get ready. Hallelujah, glory to God. Happy new month to you all. Welcome to Purpose and Marital Bliss with Pastor Honorine. I have a prophetic word for someone. God says this month, get ready. And this word is coming to us from the book of Joel chapter 2 from verse 21 to verse 25. I just finished sharing this with in a live session, and I felt so strongly led in my spirit to share it with us because many of us don't follow the live sessions. God says get ready, and this is what God has for you this month. This is what God has planned for you this month. This is the plan of God for someone in this month. God says, fear not, O land. Be glad and rejoice, for the Lord will do great things. Hallelujah. In this month that we just started, God says he will do great things in your life. He will do great things in your career. He will do great things in your finances. He will do great things for your family. He will do great things. Oh, I love the Amplified Bible rendition. The Amplified Bible says the Lord has done great things for you. It means what God has for you this month cannot be stopped. It is already done. It's already settled. The Lord has done great things for you. He says you don't need to be afraid. You don't need to wonder how the month is going to look like. God says he has done great things. He has already done it. He's done with it. He has done everything that you need to have a good month. God has done it already. Hallelujah. Verse 22 says, be not afraid, ye beasts of the field, for the pastures of the wilderness will do spring, and for the trees buried her fruit, and the fig and the vine will do yield their strength. It means your pastures will be evergreen this month. Your pastures will be evergreen this month. You will not lack anything. Your finances will flourish this month. You will not lack anything. Everything you touch this month shall prosper. You will not lack anything. It says your fields shall be evergreen. Your fields shall be evergreen. Green, evergreen talks about flourishing. Your pastures shall flourish. You will flourish in everything that you do. You will flourish in that business. You will flourish in your ministry. You will flourish at your job site. You will flourish in your marriage. You will flourish in everything you do. That organization will flourish because of you. That company will flourish because of you. That thing that you are doing, whatever, I don't know, whatever your hands find to do, but it will flourish because of you. God says it will flourish. Verse 23 says, be glad then. This month you have more reason to be glad. Remember, verse 22 said, be glad and rejoice. Now, verse 21 said, be glad and rejoice. And now God is repeating it again, be glad and rejoice. This month you have reason to celebrate. This month you have reason to be glad. This month you have reason to thank God. This month you have reason to testify. You will have reason to be glad. Laughter will not depart from your mouth this month. In the mighty name of Jesus. He says, be glad then, ye children of Zion, and rejoice for the Lord your God, for he has given you the former rain moderately, and he will cause to come down for you the rain, the former rain and the latter rain in the first month. So God will cause it to rain on you. He's giving you the former rain and the latter rain. Rain talks about the blessings of God. It means this month God is pouring out his blessings upon you. God is pouring out his blessings upon you. The blessings that you were expecting from the beginning of the year right up to this level. The breakthrough that you were expecting from the beginning of the year right up to this level. God is pouring it out on you this month in the name of Jesus. He says the former rain and the latter rain. It means some of the things that you are still trusting God for and you are thinking, and you are just saying, I just pray that before this year ends, I should receive this. God is bringing it forward and is pouring it out to you this month in the mighty name of Jesus. God is pouring it out to you this month in the mighty name of Jesus, and it's getting better. It gets better. The blessings of God are pouring upon you, but it gets better. He says, and the floors shall be full with wheat, and the vats shall overflow with wine and with oil. Hallelujah. When God told me, get ready. When God told me at the beginning of this month, he said, get ready. And then he added, he said, there shall be an overflow. And he's saying here that your floors shall be full with wheat. Your floors shall be filled with grain. It means you will not lack. This month you will not lack any good thing. This month you will not lack. You will not believe God for food. You will not, no. This month you will become a distributor of that very thing that you have been in need of. You will not lack. You will have an overflow. Come on, I hear the Holy Spirit saying this month, someone, you've got to expand your storehouse. This month you've got to expand your storehouse, because there's about to be an overflow. Because there's about to be an overflow. And then it says your vats shall be filled with wine. Wine talks about the Holy Spirit. Your vats shall be filled with wine. It means you shall be filled with the Holy Spirit this month. And who is the Holy Spirit? Is your helper. The Holy Spirit is a helper. So this month you receive help every day in the name of Jesus. Come on, as you hear a declaration and it's something you believe God for, it's something you want to connect to, then you don't wait for me to give you the opportunity to do that. I will certainly do that at the end of the video. But when you hear that, when it hits you, is the right time for you to place for you to plant a seed. It's the right time for you to connect to it, for you to say, I receive it, I connect to this in the name of Jesus. If you want the PayPal, the Cash App is in the description box. If you want this, you can use Super Chat, Super Thanks if you want. But when you hear that word and it's what you are believing God for, you've got to say, my faith says yes to this, and plant a seed to it. So God says that you will be filled, your vats will be filled with wine, and wine is talking about the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is your helper. It means you will receive help every day this month. The Holy Spirit is your comforter. This month you shall be comforted in the name of Jesus. The Holy Spirit is your teacher. This month you will know what to do at every given circumstance in the name of Jesus. The Holy Spirit is your director. He will direct and guide you. This month you will not lack, you will not make the wrong decisions. This month you will not be confused. This month you will have the necessary direction that you need in the name of Jesus. The Holy Spirit is a standby. This month when you are in urgent need for God to step in, he is there available to step in for you in the name of Jesus. The Holy Spirit is our strength. This month you shall do all things through Christ who strengthens you by the power of the Holy Spirit. By the power of the Holy Spirit. And it says your vats shall be filled with wine and with oil. Oil talks about the anointing. And what is the anointing? The anointing is God's supernatural ability added to man's natural ability to give man, so that man can yield supernatural results. So this month, God is giving you the supernatural ability in your workplace, in your career, in your company. God is giving you supernatural ideas and is giving you the supernatural wisdom of implementing it. This month, you are receiving supernatural help, supernatural ability. And I hear the Holy Spirit telling me, whatever has been difficult in time past, whatever has seemed impossible before now, this month, by reason of the anointing of God over your life, is becoming possible in the name of Jesus. Whatever has been difficult before now, by reason of the anointing of God over your life, is becoming easy in the name of Jesus. By reason of the anointing of God over your life, is becoming, impossibilities are becoming possible, and difficulties and challenges are becoming easy in the name of Jesus. The anointing is known to break the yoke. The anointing is known to break the yoke. This month, by reason of the anointing, every yoke that has been a burden to you, that has been a source of delay, that has been a source of stagnation, that yoke is broken in the name of Jesus. Every yoke of delay is broken in the name of Jesus. Every yoke of stagnation is broken in the name of Jesus. Every yoke of disappointment is broken in the name of Jesus. The yoke of marital disappointment is broken in the name of Jesus. The yoke of financial disappointment and delay is broken in the name of Jesus. Every yoke in your life is broken in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, la zibara sobra hayana manana na soana. Kayana mana karuana la rasiana barusha ha. Liza brunda rasuhanda bala rasihanda bala rusha ka. Kaliza barasuana barusha ka. Verse 25 says, and I will restore to you the years that the locust had eaten, the canker worm and the caterpillar and the palmer worm, my great army which I sent among you. This month, God says, is the month of restoration. Everything that the enemy stole from you is coming back a hundredfold. God is restoring everything that the enemy took from you. Everything that the locust ate. Everything that you lost. Restoration is coming to you this month in the mighty name of Jesus. Restoration is coming to you this month in the mighty name of Jesus. And actually, when we look, when we are looking at the month June, this is the sixth month of the year, and the Bible tells us in the book of Luke that when Elizabeth was 6 months pregnant, when Elizabeth was 6 months pregnant, an angel appeared to Mary and announced to Mary that Elizabeth was pregnant. And Mary visited Elizabeth. And the moment Mary visited Elizabeth, the Bible says the baby in her womb began to leap. We have not had any record of the baby in her womb moving before now. Someone, by reason of this month, God says this month will be a month where God announces you in the name of Jesus. This month, God will announce you in the mighty name of Jesus. This month, God will announce you in the mighty name of Jesus. This month, God will send help to you. God will connect you to the right people. People that will make your baby leap. People that will make your baby leap in the mighty name of Jesus. And I just heard the Holy Spirit tell me to tell someone that someone this month, God is taking you from surviving to thriving. This month, God is taking you from surviving to thriving. God is giving you an overflow. God is giving you an overflow. God is taking you from that place. I don't know who this is for, but someone, I see God moving you. I see a relocation. God is moving you from that place where you are now, where you are just surviving, to another location where you'll be thriving. I don't know who is trusting God to move. God is moving you to that new location in the name of Jesus. And God is giving you greater opportunities, better opportunities in that new location in the name of Jesus. God is taking you from a place of surviving to a place of thriving. And this for someone has to do with relocation. This for someone has to do with God moving you physically from one place to another. But the place where God is taking you, you are going to thrive there. The place where God is taking you, you are going to have a flourishing life. The place where God is taking you, you will prosper. Opportunities will open. God will open amazing doors before you in the mighty name of Jesus. This is a good month for you. Everything that you've been trusting God for from the beginning of the year up till now, God is granting it to you this month. Everything that you've been believing God, everything you've been believing God for, He is granting it to you this month. This month, you shall be so happy. You will testify to the goodness of God. This is your best month this far in this year. In the mighty name of Jesus. Did we receive the words and the prayer with gladness? If you did, then this is the time you thank God by planting a prophetic seed. This is a prophetic instruction for someone for this month. If you have been following my videos, you should know I don't do this. But if I do this, it's because I'm strongly led in my spirit. This is a prophetic instruction for this month. Plant a seed. A seed that is a defining seed, is a prophetic seed. Not the kind of seed that you just plant. You just, not an offering. A seed that will define your month. So this seed is guaranteed to do 3 major things for you this month. The first thing is that this seed will ensure that you have a month of overflow. This seed, God said, God says, get ready for an overflow. This seed will guarantee that you have an overflow. Secondly, this seed will take someone from surviving to thriving. This seed will take someone from surviving to thriving, especially the person that is trusting God for relocation. And then thirdly, this seed is going to make sure that your month flourish. It's going to make sure that your month is preserved and protected and that it flourish, that you have green pastures all throughout this month. These three things, and three talks about divinity. These three things, connecting you to your seed, is going to get divinity involved in your life this month. In the mighty name of Jesus. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he cause his face to shine upon you. And may he be gracious to you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you. Shalom.